So all of your favorite channels seem to make the backgrounds disappear as they lay themselves over their game because of a little tool called a green screen. But you don't want to spend $300-$400 on a professional green screen? Well, that's why we're going to show you how to make one for $25.
What?
Yeah, I'm not kidding. Let's go. Hey guys, it's the Drama King. Thank you so much for joining us for another video. If you have any other questions or ever want to ask me anything at all about life, wrestling, gaming, streaming, Twitch, whatever it is, I do stream on Twitch. Check it out below. 3-4 days a week so you can cop on in the chat, join the Drama Club community, and hang out with all of us because we want to hang out with you. But also make sure you like, subscribe, hit those alerts for this channel right here so you know anytime Drama King Matt puts video out into the universe. But today, we want to take a look at green screens. Everybody seems to have a green screen, at least many of your or my favorite streamers. It's nice, it takes away a little bit of the camera so you can see more of the game. It eliminates a lot of that square box. It frees up a lot of screen real estate for you. And quite frankly, it just kind of looks pretty neat. But the trouble is you go on the internet and you see a lot of these, check Amazon, couple hundred dollars, all the way up to $500, quote unquote professional green screens that you can hang up behind you pull tight and have all stretched out and perfectly all this, that, and the other. And that's great. Those do work impeccably. But I'm here to show you you can do it much, much cheaper. So what we're working with here is actually a $25 piece of cloth from the fabric store. Yeah, that's right. I went to the fabric store, just got a couple of lengths of wide, bright green cloth. Make sure it's not too shiny or reflective because that can cause issues with the green screen. But make sure it's unlike anything you're gonna wear on stream because that's the biggest thing. We're gonna be editing out this color on your camera so we can see everything behind it. Now for me, I just drape this on my wall and use a thumbtack. Stretch it nice and tight so there's no wrinkles and it's that simple. I'm gonna hang it here on the sign so you see what it looks like. Now, I have a lot of stuff on my wall here now. I've changed my background because I did use a green screen for a little while, but now I chose to highlight the background and the things I'm doing in my stream room. So I decided to go back to a square camera base. But the green screen is still a great tool and there is still a great way you can do it without spending a lot of money. So I'm gonna set up a couple of stands just so I can hang my green screen and show you exactly what I'm working with.
A few moments later.
And what I have behind me is an old extendable sign that I've used for different projects. I'm just showing you the backside of it because this is where I'm gonna hang what I'm using for the green screen. For you, it'll be much easier. You don't need anything like this. I'm just using this to kind of cover the wall that I have now, just to give you kind of a blank canvas.
1 eternity later.
I've got the green screen, the cloth draped up over my sign. And for you, right now it looks okay, but for you, it'll be even better because again, if you have that blank wall, just tack it up, pull it tight, no wrinkles, that'll make your image even better. But even this kind of wonky setup that I'm working with, I will show you, will work just fine. And again, we're talking less than $30 for this green screen. Now, one of the biggest keys is gonna be lighting. And again, you don't have to get expensive. For me, I'm using a set of Amazon lights that I got for $40. These are not fancy key lights. These are not professional photography lights. Nothing like, you just need enough light to light up your face and to get some light on the background because if it's too dark and shadowy, you're not gonna be able to get that editing effect out. That chroma key, as you'll see in a minute, will not be able to edit out everything. But as long as you can get enough bright lighting like this, you will be just fine. And again, I can link those lights in the description below. They're super cheap, super effective, and a great way to start your DIY streaming setup, especially if you want to do a green screen. Once we have it up, we've got some decent lights going. What do we do next to make sure I'm now floating on my screen? How do I get rid of my background? Very, very simple. It's not some fancy graphic technology. Let's switch over to the display over here. And this little red box, as you see, that's where my camera is gonna pop up in a second after we turn it back on. But first, we go to the source, which is our camera, which for me is the Canon. I'm going to right click, and we're gonna go right here to filters. And now see, there you see me again, standing right behind my green screen. You've got audio, video, and effect filters. Now what we wanna do is go to effect filters, and it's one of the first ones, chroma key. Chroma basically means color. We're gonna key it out of the scene. So you can call it whatever you want. Call it green screen, call it whatever. Already I'm floating because green is the default. Now you can mess with all of this to make it, so we are at 400 in similarity here, right? If I get rid of all of it, it goes back to normal. If I go super high, it deletes me out of the scene because it makes everything blend together. But we were right at 400. So we can, this, honestly, the default numbers worked pretty well for me as long as I had decent lighting. So as you'll see, I'm floating here, just hit close. And now I'm gonna bring up my source, unblind it. And there I am. Look at, floating in multiple scenes. I'm floating in multiple scenes. Look at me dancing in the corner, floating on multiple scenes. And if we go back to our regular, you see me, I'm floating here in this blank black void. And at this point, I can literally bring any image behind me. Or I can take, the camera will go anywhere with an image of me like this. So I could put a picture behind me. I could put, you know, you can do funny backgrounds, but most importantly, you can bring in your game or your video display or your capture, and you put that behind you and you shrink this down and you'll just be in the corner, just like you saw on the other side of things. I'm here floating in my blank void. Thanking you for watching this video. And that's how you make, guys, that's how you make a $25 green screen for you to float in front of any game you want, any video you want. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe to this channel so you know anytime the Drama King goes live. Come to the Drama Club. Thank you for hanging out and have fun streaming.